We are here at San Francisco, California's Bayview Opera House for a community screening of The Waiting Room, also with a follow-up discussion with a diverse panel. We want to have a community discussion on how healthcare reform is going to be changing the community's outlook and changing how healthcare's outlook will be. And so we'll be having some guests speak on that as well. So I'm Dr. Marcus Lorenzo Penn. We're joined here by Jeffrey Betcher of Quesada Gardens. When we think about the healthcare reform law, it's looking to do a lot of restructuring and bring a lot more health communities together to better understand what's going on. So your organization helps to bring communities together in another way. Could you share with us what that is?
We build community gardens, community gathering spaces, art projects, and communications and social history projects. Mm-hmm. Really, whatever will bring people together across the lines that typically separate us, we find produces amazing results on all fronts, including the health front. In our community gardens, people are typically eating better, nutrition is better, people are more physically active because they're moving around. And so there are direct health benefits. But I think what is the most important is that we're bringing people together and building social cohesion.
Yes.
That social capital, that community unity, has direct health benefits and is underrated, I think. Mm-hmm. Even when we have a problem, you know, if we know our neighbor, the chances of coming out, you know, on the good end of that problem,
for sure,
go way up. So I would say if everybody in Bayview Hunters Point knew their neighbor, health would be remarkably and measurably improved.
Mm-hmm. That's a really good point. And as we're here also for the waiting room screening, which gives, again, day in the life of a county hospital, county ER hospital, I would imagine that having healthier communities, communities that are, you know, more cohesive, may help to decrease those ER visits.
Absolutely.
You know, having more vegetables with your community gardens, knowing that someone's looking out for one another, I think that that's a good thing.
And we can speak for one another. Mm-hmm. You know, often when you go to the emergency room, the clinician may not know very much about the neighborhood you come from. Mm-hmm. There might be all sorts of critical pieces of information that are off the map. But if the friend who happened to take them to the hospital knows all of that, I mean, there are benefits there, too. We've actually worked with doctors at San Francisco General Hospital in the community to build those sorts of bridges and relationships, because that's going to improve patient health.
Yes, yes. You know, and physicians are always speaking about, you know, eat more fruits and vegetables. You know, I think it might need to shift to grow more of your own fruits and vegetables, and that's where the Quesada Gardens can come
and
in.
Do it with your neighbors.
Mm-hmm.
It's more fun that way. Anyway.
Mm-hmm. Most definitely. How would you say the community has been receptive to the organization?
It's hard to argue with planting flowers and fruits and vegetables, painting pictures on walls. Mm-hmm. So the community is very receptive. And in fact, each of our projects is independently led by people from in the community. Mm-hmm. So people who are already interested in doing that, we're building capacity around them.
Right.
I live on the block where Quesada Gardens is. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't be doing this work if I weren't a resident.
Mm-hmm.
And there are social networks built around each project.
Yes.
So the community is involved. So, of course, they're supportive with their own work. And those who aren't directly involved, you know, will drive by and honk and wave and smile, come out and get a hug once in a while. And so everybody's very supportive. And all our projects are clustered in the heart of Bayview. So you can really see them all in an hour walk around Bayview.
Mm-hmm.
You can see a lot of gardens in our projects.
Mm. Longevity is a real important part of any organization, particularly a community-based organization. How long has the Quesada Gardens, the concept been, and then when it got enacted to have soil and connecting with community?
You know, it started because Carl Page and Annette Smith were planting on my block. They were planting flowers here and there. So that was 2001.
Okay. Oh, wow.
At the tail end of 2001. So we're over 11 years old now. We chose the name in 2003 and started really doing the organizing and meeting and documentation of the project.
Mm-hmm.
So depending on how you do the math, between 10, 11, 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
We have very little funding. We're volunteer driven. People don't understand, I think, what to do with community builders, with grassroots organizations. There aren't categories out there for funding it.
Yeah.
So that's been a big challenge. And I think societally we need to fix that. We need to figure that out. Because the stuff that's happening at the grassroots, that's where it's at. In all of these small informal groups, whatever the association is, I mean, at the end of the day, when this is a healthy, thriving community, it's going to be those little groups in church basements and meeting halls around the neighborhood that will have made that happen.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to find a way to directly support this work, I think.
I got you. Now, if there's, I'll give you the last word here. If someone is on the fence about starting their own community garden, again, in an urban environment, what would you say is some of their first steps to get that going, to take that leap?
I'd say talk to your neighbors. I mean, first and foremost, talk to your neighbors and make sure it's what they want too. And probably you're going to find a lot of support. And a lot of people will come out of the woodwork who know about gardening and love it. And things just start happening organically. Sometimes you can't avoid having a community garden.
Mm-hmm. Indeed. Well, thank you so much, Jeffrey. Appreciate you sharing about Casada Gardens. And I'm looking to grow my own garden soon too.
Amen, brother.
Thanks so much. Thank you.